The National Transportation Safety Board began its investigation today into the Bay Bridge crash that sent a car and its driver plunging into the Chesapeake last week. This is, we've learned, that state investigators have begun reconstructing that crash. 11 News reporter George Lettis is live in the newsroom with the details. George.
Well, Donna, the NTSB is involved to see if bridges nationwide need to learn a lesson from this. Meanwhile, state investigators are going over the crash step by step to see if anyone should face charges. Authorities say NTSB investigators examined the vehicles involved in the crash and went to the Bay Bridge to speak with bridge operators and engineers and do a drive-over. It's all in an effort to see if the federal agency will make a nationwide safety recommendation for all bridges following the crash that caused Morgan Lake and her Chrysler Sebring to plunge 40 feet off the bridge and into the Chesapeake Bay last Friday. Police say a tractor trailer hit her car from behind and pushed it over a Jersey wall.
The NTSB investigation is going to look more closely at what kind of design standards you have for a facility. People have talked about the barriers, so there's focus on that.
Which begs the question, should Jersey walls be the only barrier between traffic and the water at the lower end of the bridge?
It is in compliance with the design standards that were in place in 1986 when those barriers were built, and it's commonly used on interstate bridges throughout the country.
Governor O'Malley talked about the crash for the first time today.
The bridge is structurally sound, and yet at the same time, when something like this happens, you have a responsibility to look at this accident, to deconstruct it, and figure out if there are any sorts of changes that we can make.
The Maryland Transportation Authority released data showing the average number of crashes on the Bay Bridge is much lower than on roads statewide. From 2008 to 2011, the bridge averaged 43 crashes per 100 million vehicle miles traveled. On state roads, 166 crashes. Meanwhile, the state's crash reconstruction investigation is underway. The vehicles are strategically positioned in a warehouse right now, and data from the tractor trailer that records its speed and steering is being examined to find out what role, if any, the bridge's design played and what role the drivers played in this horrific crash.
We hope it'll give people some assurances, or it will give us some ideas of what might need to be done, what message we need to give to the motorists.
And the Maryland Transportation Authority's final report could take weeks to finish. In the newsroom, George Lettis, WBAL-TV 11 News.